done yet. Yes.
I concur. Right.
It's just not done yet. Huh. You got lots of good stuff. You got good panels up there. You got good quality Morningstar controllers and all kinds of goodies hooked up in a nice big old inverter down there, which apparently seems to be working all right.
Oh, the thing rocks.
Yeah. And you got a big converter down here to run your 12-volt systems and charge your battery. Well, it seems to me like you have all the expensive stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You already own them.
Yeah, we already got all the goodies.
We want to make sure it's stuff in the
kind of put it all in the right order.
Yeah, that's it right there.
Get it all in the right order and make sure everything is protected by fuses or circuit breakers.
Yeah, so we don't burn
out. Usually put at least a thermal breaker.
Something.
Like a 50-amp thermal breaker in line with stop. So if you get a short, thermal breaker will kick right out.
Yeah.
And it stays open, and then pretty soon it'll try to close again, and if it's still got an overload, it'll pop open.
Yep.
But the nice thing about them, you don't have to hand reset them, and you don't have to replace them unless they burn out.
Right. Unless you fry it.
If they burn out, then you have to.
Yeah.
Most of the time, you don't have to replace them. And they don't cost them more time and labor doing it than you really will in parts, because you already have them, most importantly. Mm-hmm. And if you do part of the labor yourself, reduces it even. No. Well, I put no fuses whatsoever in here. None. No shutoff whatsoever in here. But the trouble is, the shutoff needs to be here. Hey, putting a shutoff in here, so I can't reach it.
Can we put it through right there? In the wall? Right here?
You know, where I can just. Well, turn it off right here, chunk.
You have to go through the switch. So in other words, you want to break this connection here and this one. Mm-hmm. So these two leads would then come around over here.
Right.
And one's a negative, one's a positive. So we only need to break the one. So you'd bring this lead around here, hook it to one of them.
Right.
And on the other side, it has to go back to there.
Sure, yeah.
Has to go back and come, so that all this comes through the switch and back to here.
So
I guess you could mount it on this wall here and attach it from the back, but usually most of those are not made to go through a wall.
Yeah, this is a through the bulkhead jobber.
Right on the surface.
See, that whole back box will come off if you want to. And just pull it off.
Yeah. Most of the time, you mount it on the wall like that.
Mm-hmm.
And the wires come in the bulkhead
sides. Or flush or. Said,
you would have to. Yeah, actually, drill a hole out big enough for this whole saw. Mm-hmm. Take this cover off and put this through the wall.
Huh.
And then run this to that. Oh, yeah, you could do that. Yeah, that would disconnect that going to the batteries. It would be good if you disconnect, and they usually indicate a switch between the solar panels.
But you have something to turn that.
Well, I see the way it's wired. To turn them all off, you have one.
Yeah, you need
and
two.
And one over there, you have two.
Mm-hmm.
And they aren't tied together. Separated them, small panels, big panels, one on one controller, one on the other. Well, this was just really wasn't any reason for that, other than you have so many of them, you need to spread them out over a couple of terminal blocks because of too many wires.
Yeah.
So to the solar panel, those two coming back from the panel. Looks like you do have it parallel.
Yeah.
If this line here goes to the whole bank of batteries or just the first bank?
I think it goes to what he was saying was the middle.
In the middle?
Yeah, and it's down here. It comes in by the hydraulic jack. I was checking it out. I think I found these cables anyway. I haven't crawled underneath
so
yet.
So this red lead is attached down at the center?
Down at those lugs down there in the inverter bay.
Yeah, you got four on one side, four on the other, right?
Yeah.
four batteries over here on this side of the coach, four batteries on the other side. So he has that feeding the plus side of both of them. There's a T down here or something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, they both come together apparently.
Okay.
It's supposed to be electrically in the middle.
Okay. So anyway, you need one of these would need to install one over here.
Yeah.
And make a short lead. Yeah, go down to welding shop and buy another piece of 1/0.
Mm-hmm.
And put terminals on it and run it from there to here. Short one. Well, bring it over to the corner and up so it's not in the way of the bridge.
Right.
So we'd have to do that. All right, that takes care of that. Now, you got some monitoring that you do. What are you monitoring? Your panel over here, anything?
Well, these you know, do the volts, amps, they try to start things. This here isn't used. This is for the wind turbine, and I didn't. This is the on-off for the gray inverter down here.
So this guy was for your wind generator?
Yeah.
Which you're not using?
Nope.
And this guy over here, what's this?
That's the brake for the wind generator.
Oh, okay. Got a dynamic brake on it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Shorts it.
And that's what just...
For the other inverter down there, that gray one. See, that was originally running the coach. And then I realized I didn't have any way to charge this thing. Except for the solar cells.
That is switching on and off. Now you're talking about the 80 amp converter.
That's the other gray inverter down there. The one that's has the four plugs.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's okay. That one.
That one.
And they put in that one and this switch here.
But you just said that was not hooked up?
Well, it's not used.
Okay.
It's hooked up. It can turn it on and power stuff with it, but it's not wired.
Oh,
it's not powering anything.
Okay.
Unless I plug it in.
So, basically then, he has parallels these two together. Huh. What do you get over here? That one. Okay. The charge leads coming out of here going to the same terminal there. So it does have a parallel together, both these boxes on the output.
Oh, okay.
Input is feeding one with the small panels, one with the big panels.
Yeah.
Is the way he's feeding them.
Probably be better if we at least balanced them.
Yeah.
Put the same wattage
on
each one.
Not very well balanced at all, because you're going to have one here reading entirely something different.
Yeah, indeed.
The 27.4, that must be the input voltage.
That's what the bank's sitting at. Right now, it seems to work pretty well on that. It doesn't, you know, do weird readings or nothing.
3.2 amps.
Yeah, it's just sitting there floating.
Just floating.
Yeah.
Three batteries must be charged up.
Yeah. I wanted to, you know, reroute those.
But there's room here.
Yeah.
I think we could do put one of those in there.
Huh.
But you really need to shut down. Right in the middle so you can shut everything down on if you need to.
Right, right. You'll turn this thing off sometimes.
So we need a couple of foot of welding lead, a couple connectors on, and holes on a hole through here.
Mm-hmm.
This single.
I think it's double.
Hole saw a hole through there to fit this guy in it so you can turn it on and off over here.
Huh.
And that would disengage that. there's your fuse on your... Fridge has a fuse in the line, but
yeah.
Okay, these go down and hook to the batteries, but do they pass through a fuse?
Right, let's go.
Now I see that, but now let's go see where the other end is.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want this end here. These two leads here are coming down a wall going
in here.
Over here.
I think they go down and through to the other side where he says the middle was. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
There's two, yeah, okay. He's got the same thing linking this over there to it too. So there's two sets of those coming in. So one of them's this and one of them's that.
House switch here to switch one.
To turn off the house battery or the What's that even hooked to? Let's hook to this converter. Let's hear.
See? It's hooked to that converter, so that operates that converter just like it was a battery, you know, the regular battery bank.
Uh-huh.
It's 60 amp, so it handles everything pretty well.
Sure.
You don't have any, you know, browning out or anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. I think I know where those come through. I'll show you.
I was over here checking it out. There's two sets of those cables, and they got to be that, you know. That one-aught stuff.
They're going, and the negative side is going out through the wall. Yeah, going out through the wall.
They're both
that
exiting.
That red
out.
Thing
yeah.
right there is. Those are thermal fuses, but that was probably here for the coach.
Yeah, and that was all there.
Just feeding the end of it.
Huh.
And the big heavy black leads going through the wall there, probably going over to the other side, I guess.
Yep.
Well, he must be attached somewhere.
Well,
the leads coming from the
you'll see when you get over there, there's two sets of that one-aught stuff coming out. Right here. There's two of them right here, and two of them right here. Right? There's these two one-aughts. And then there's these two.
And he put another couple of those terminals up in here.
This is what he was saying is considered the middle. And there's this that goes over to the inverter.
You know, he's feeding it from the center.
And that's the one fuse we got.
And that fuse there, what is that fuse?
It's a 400 amp.
And it's going between the full output of this thing.
Yeah.
And that's going
to the inverter here.
That goes to the inverter.
Yep.
Okay, so he has one fuse, and the fuse is going to the inverter, and it's a big 400 amp.
Yep.
Okay. So that's the only place it's fused.
Yep, that's it.
The other side doesn't have any fuse at all.
Nope, nothing. And then it's daisy chained. So this is just getting pounded.
And it needs
this should be over here. This ground right here should be over here. Or that positive should be over here. You know, with these properly joined together.
Uh-huh.
Series parallel. Not daisy chain, that's
so
not good.
Needs a fuse on the other side.
Oh, watch you hit.
That pack over there isn't fused at all.
No.
So it needs a fuse. You're not seeing a whole lot of things.
Just protection and.
You just need some protection.
And just wire up the banks right. Yeah, and wire up the banks right.
Yeah, over here, that switch is just. That just power going to the inverter, right?
To that, yeah, that little switching that. Converter there, the 24 to 12 volt. This little bugger right here.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's supplying to the.
It's a little Samlec SDC60 Samlec converter.
So that's giving you 12 volts in the house?
Yeah.
And you're turning it on and off with that switch?
Or the, also the house battery switch on the door works as well. So I don't ever mess with this.
Okay, so it's got a manual switch. So
it's got that one, you know, beside the door, so you just donk.
So the output of these batteries isn't connected to any fuse.
Nope.
And the house is protected by, there's four, probably 50 amp thermal breakers in that block right there.
Is that these here?
No, back at the back, on the wall.
Oh, these here?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I got you.
Each one of those is separate. There's just a hole with one.
Right.
And there's four of them there. So that's okay.
That's good, yeah.
Yeah, so you got some fuse going in.
Yeah.
But you don't have any protection for this side over here at all.
Mm-mm.
So you need a fuse block over here and cable going to it, a heavy duty fuse. So if any of these gets shorted or anything happens to it, it blows that fuse instead of burning. Man, that wire just heat up like it.
Oh, right now.
Oh, man.
Right now.
Fast.
Glows and drops. That's it. smoking, glowing, dropping. That's what happens.
It would get bad really quick.
Yes, it would. It'd burst into flames. I've seen that happen. I have melted down welding cables before. You know.
Sure.
So that was Lee Braithwait. He was an electrician for a long time, a journeyman electrician, and still carries all the certifications. And now for a living, he is a professional solar energy system installer. He doesn't cost very much, and he works down in Yuma, Arizona all winter long, so he'll only be here in Newport for another week or two. So Mike is going to go ahead and do the work that has been pointed out that needs done. And most of that is making the system safe. The way that it's hooked up is not to code, not safe at all. It's missing vital shutoff switches and fuses in the wires, as well as being just hooked up wrong to the batteries, as so many people have pointed out. So now that we've had an expert go over it with us, go over it with Mike, we'll be able to get the parts and part two, get the work done. So we're feeling pretty good about it. Stop.